Producing a sufficient amount of food is one of the biggest challenges farmers are facing today. But is modern agriculture compatible with biodiversity and environmental protection? Can plant protection products ensure a good crop yield without damaging the environment?
That is exactly what we are working towards. We study the effects of the substances we produce on the environment and ecosystems to ensure sustainability. And this is why product safety and environmental protection is of such a high priority for BASF. Ecotoxicology studies the side effects of substances on the environment. At BASF, we investigate how substances react in the ecosystem and how organisms in the ecosystem respond to these substances. Healthy soil is required for farmers to be able to produce crops year after year. The functions performed by soil must be maintained to ensure a good yield. Soil is a very complex system that contains a vast quantity of organisms which are ultimately responsible for these functions. We study a few key representative soil organisms and perform ecotoxicological tests with them to ensure that these soil functions are maintained. For example, we study the earthworm, Isania fetida, the species you find in compost. The earthworm fulfills critical functions, such as aerating the soil and decomposing organic materials. We also test the springtail, which is a much smaller organism, which also lives in soil systems and is important for nutrient cycling and organic material decomposition.
Farmland is often located in the vicinity of water, such as rivers, lakes, and the sea. That means we also have to protect aquatic organisms from plant protection products. Aquatic ecotoxicology aims to provide complete protection for aquatic ecosystems. The main organisms tested are fish, invertebrates, algae, and aquatic plants. My main area of research is aquatic invertebrates such as Daphnia, also known as water fleas. We conduct two different standard studies at BASF. First, there's the short-term study, which lasts 48 hours. Here we observe the acute effects of the plant protection products on the Daphnia. Then there's the long-term study, which runs for 21 days. This assesses chronic effects, such as long-term survival and reproduction.
Why birds? Because especially farmland birds are my interest, because they have to deal with very rapidly changing environments, because a farmland is always changing very rapidly in a season. So for them it's a challenge to keep up with these changes. And I've been working basically all my life with birds. For birds we do generic studies. So these are studies, first of all we do studies to see which bird species do occur in different crops, for example in these citrus orchards, but also in olive orchards or in cereals. We do radio tracking studies. These are studies where we try to see how much time do specific birds, species of birds spend in specific crops. We do dietary studies where we study the diet of different birds during the breeding season. And besides birds, we also do mammal studies, basically the same. So which species occur in which crop, how much time do they spend there, and what do they eat there.
As bees are an important part of agriculture, we think it is important that our products do not affect them. This simply means that we must ensure that the application of plant protection products does not harm bees or put bees at risk, so that they can pollinate, collect nutrients, and replenish their food reserves, which are important for the colony's survival. In order to verify that our products are not harming bees, we begin in the lab, in order to determine how our plant protection products affect mortality and behavior. We then go to higher tier testing to investigate the entire colony, as the sustainability and survivability of the colony is our main goal. One type of study that we use is the bee tunnel to simulate a realistic scenario. This study not only looks at individual bees, but the entire colony. For the tunnel study, we grow plants that bees find attractive and place them inside a large enclosed area known as a tunnel. Then we introduce a bee population into the same tunnel, apply the plant protection product while the bees are on the plants, and observe the effects on the colony. We then compare the effects of the plant protection product to that of bees in a tunnel that was not sprayed with plant protection products to determine if there are effects. This enables us to compare the behaviors of treated and non-treated bees.
Und anhand dessen können wir eben vergleichen, wie verhalten sich nicht behandelte Bienen im Vergleich zu behandelten Bienen.
Using bee tracking, it is relatively easy for us to track individual bees. Sensors on the hive entrance detect bees carrying a tiny microchip on their back. This has the advantage that we can simply intercept bees entering or exiting the hive. Then we can treat them with specific plant protection products and subsequently conduct behavioral tests. For example, we can observe whether a plant protection product can impact the ability of a bee to return to the hive after exposure. The results of our studies are then summarized and are then used in a risk assessment. The risk assessment is then forwarded to the authorities, with whom we then discuss the results to obtain authorization and/or registration. In new product development, a whole set of studies and requirements must be fulfilled in order for registration and to be able to use the product. Products have to show good efficacy, better efficacy than the previous market standard, but also be environmentally safe. This means providing new solutions that must be safe for the operator, the consumer, and to the environment, while reconciling the needs of agriculture and environmental protection.
In everything we do, both now and in the future, we strive to ensure a healthy and biodiverse environment. That's what responsible chemistry means to us.
BASF. We create chemistry.